Okay, today is Sunday, July 24th, 2006. Now, this park has been on steroid for many months, and the blood test shows the slight leukocytosis and neutrophilia, indicating bacterial infection of the bloodstream. Now, you can see pustules on the skin. This is due to bacterial infection. Then the owner didn't put the e-collar. Now, okay, this is considered the four where it let down. Now, if the four contact each other, apparently it's like the tail in the bulldog. They have this eczema. Then the pug licks it. And the bacteria just form. And the armpit's the same area there, armpit. So we put the pug on the antibiotics. This is interesting because the mouth didn't get it. Normally the pug's face will have all these pimples. But in this pug, which is very unusual because his face is clean, don't have this folliculitis, which I had in other pugs. So clean. So we are waiting for the results of the allergen test. Other than these four areas anymore? Okay, let me stand up. Let me stand up. And then, okay. No, wait. So you can see the urticaria lumps, which is very obvious. The owner is switching to the owner can hold it. She's switching over to the hypoallergenic diet first, but haven't switched 100%, right?
Yeah, sorry.
Now I notice that ear is not so red as last time. Is it why? What's the reason?
I'm not.
Oh, you stopped putting the ear ointment?
And there's no ear ointment, no ear drop.
She stopped, but not so reddish. But
it's
a bit
red. The left ear that gets a bit more. She's only
is it less red?
With water.
Is it less red?
It looks less red. It doesn't
definitely
smell as bad.
Okay, so this dog has this bladder infection, and then you give vinegar. Still giving? Vinegar every two times a day, right?
Yes.
The only problem with giving all these things is that it affects the hypoallergenic diet, because hypoallergenic diet is supposed to be given 100% without other things like treats or additional things like vinegar or this. So if possible, then give less. I mean once in 2 days or something. Now you put her on the course antibiotic first, and you know that she's allergic to nitrofurin, which you showed me already. So we wouldn't give that one. And so I was telling her to start on Atopica, which is a substitute for steroids. But this is also an immunosuppressive drug. But it's not a steroidal drug now. And this one has been given for maybe 2 months, but not necessarily every day. As I noticed, this is not a very serious one. So wait till the hypoallergenic diet, see whether it works or not. If it works, of course, then everything should be better than the taking steroids or drugs. So this is the plan.